Being the first bank in South Dakota was the easy part, earning the confidence of local farmers, helping families account for their dreams, and securing the future for countless businesses took us a little longer. We owe it to the hard workers, big dreamers, and forward thinkers out there. Thank you for making South Dakota a great place to call home.
Hello and welcome to Sertoma Park in beautiful Yankton, South Dakota. I'm Zach Spear on 5-Star Streaming on YouTube alongside Gage Ravelet and Corbin Gunther as we await the matchup between the Yankton Gazelles and the Sioux Falls Roosevelt Rough Riders. Coming into this matchup, Sioux Falls Roosevelt 1-2, the Yankton Gazelles 0-2, and the Rough Riders fresh off of a win. They started 0-2, but they were winners in their last matchup. For the Gazelles, they started their season last week, and it was a Thursday-Friday situation in which we saw them fall in the first game. Their first game was against Brandon Valley. They then took on Harrisburg, I was getting them reversed because last year they opened the season against Harrisburg, and the second game was against Brandon Valley. This year, it got flipped. So for Sioux Falls Roosevelt, their first matchup came up against Brookings, in which they had their first season opener. They had their home opener all in the same. They took on Brookings, in which they lost 5-6. They then had to travel to take on Mitchell, and they lost 2-12. And again, in their latest matchup, they did come out on top against O'Gorman. That score was 8-7, so a close game and a couple for the Rough Riders. Two games that were within one run, so if it comes down to crunch time, could be experience that we see take over. As for the Gazelles, in their first game of the year, that took place last Thursday. Luckily, I was able to head out to Brandon Valley to cover that one. Brandon Valley came out on top. The score was 4-7, and then the home opener for the Gazelles against Harrisburg this last Friday, so not much for turnaround, as it's been game here for Yankton. No practice to kind of work on those kinks, as you'll hear later, me and Coach Muth did get a chance to talk about. But against Harrisburg, they lost 1-18. And I tell you what, that Harrisburg team, I mean, that was, it didn't matter if you're throwing beach balls or BBs, that thing was getting hit hard, and we saw a few home runs, and it was just a very good team that took over in the game. After a couple, Yankton was very much in it, and it was really one bad inning that Harrisburg took advantage of, put up a ton of runs, and there's your final score of 18-1. Of course, first pitch for today is slotted for 6 o'clock, but in upcoming action for the Gazelles, they also play later this week. They have three more games this week. On Thursday, they take on Rapid City Central, a home game at 5 o'clock. And then on Friday, they have a doubleheader against two separate teams. So not really a doubleheader, but they play twice. The first game is against Spearfish. That one is at noon. And the second game of the day will be against Pier TF Riggs. And that game takes place at 4 o'clock. The Gazelles then have to travel to both T-Area and Sturgis Brown and Rapid City Stevens. Now that Sturgis Brown, Rapid City Stevens, they luckily got the games on back-to-back days. Hopefully they'll be able to stay out and not have to make that drive two separate times. They then take on Watertown. They travel to Aberdeen Central and a home game against Vermilion. That should be a fun one. They travel to take on O'Gorman, first game in May. And then with four games left in the season, at home against Mitchell, they travel to take on Brookings, travel to face Sioux Falls Lincoln, and they end the regular season with a home matchup against Sioux Falls Jefferson. Again, I did get a chance to talk with head coach Jill Muth of the Yankton Gazelles. When we return, we'll see what she thinks about this upcoming matchup, what she's seen from her team so far, as the Gazelles in the field currently for warm-ups, getting ready for this game again at 6 o'clock for first pitch. We'll be back with our chat with head coach Jill Muth in a moment on 5-Star Streaming on YouTube.
Choose Floortech Cleaning and Restoration, locally owned by Tom and Nancy Langdon since 1994, and because they offer so many services for residential and commercial properties, like carpet cleaning, mold testing and removal, fire and smoke damage, and duct cleaning. Floortech Cleaning and Restoration also offers emergency services in Yankton, Mitchell, Southeast South Dakota, Northeast Nebraska, and Norfolk.
Whether a broken pipe or flooding rains, when your home or floor is wet, call Floortech.
Located at 220 East 3rd Street in Yankton.
Horizon Healthcare in Yankton offers medical, dental, and behavioral health services for all. from tooth pains to aches and pains. Our new location on 920 Broadway Avenue is a comfortable, expanded space where everyone is welcome. Whether insured, uninsured, Medicaid, or Medicare, here in Yankton, we care for all. And that's what we care about most. Call to schedule your appointment at Horizon Healthcare.
Interior technicians.
I'm ready for my big role, Jerry.
What do you mean?
You said I'd be in your next 30 commercials.
No. I said InTech has over 30 years of commercial cleaning experience. You know, like offices, so they can ensure happy visitors and a healthy workforce.
So the shoot's in an office? I can make that work.
Oh my goodness. When you need it clean, call the InTech team.
Kaiser Heating and Cooling is your local source for heat and glow fireplaces, gas inserts, and wood stoves. Also home to the Train HVAC systems, humidifiers, dehumidifiers, and mini splits. Whether building or remodeling, the team of experts will get you the right size of HVAC system for your home or business. The ductwork is made in-house, and then the installers will get your Train system installed in no time to keep you cool in the summer and warm in the winter. Kaiser Heating and Cooling since 1948.
New year, new flooring. I plan on saying hello with new flooring from Larson Carpet in Yankton. Larson Carpet will help with design and installation. They have a great selection of carpet, vinyl, luxury vinyl plank, hardwood, and tile. Stop in and let them help you get a new look in the new year. Larson Carpet at 208 Walnut Street in the Meridian District in Yankton. For the best flooring for your space, lifestyle, and budget, see Larson Carpet.
On our coaches conversations, talking with head coach Jill Muth of the Yankton Gazelles. Coach, you've now got two games in. What have you seen from your team so far?
We have, I think, definitely from game one to game two, taken a step in the right direction with some good positive at bats. You know, I think we definitely have things we need to keep working on and cleaning up on the defensive side. And, you know, like we talked about the other night, man, we ran into Harrisburg and they were just kind of a juggernaut. That was, you know, one of those games you just forget it and move on, because really, you know, we're not, you know, not in with something I don't want my pitchers to remember. And it's something that, you know, I think we can use as we ended the game with some positive at bats, and then we're going to move on to the next one.
Absolutely. And something we had talked about and you've mentioned was the bats making more contact in the second game compared to the first. Have you also been seeing those improvements in practice as well?
Well, you know, to be honest with you, we played Thursday, we played Friday, it rained all weekend, we play Monday.
Oh, yeah. Of course, yeah. How could I forget? Yeah.
So, unfortunately for us, we haven't had a lot of practice time, you know, and that's the down thing, too. You know, as we get going, it'd be nice to have a chance to get some live at-bats in or, you know, get the pitching machine out, and definitely that's what we're going to do tomorrow and Wednesday before we play again Thursday and Friday. But, yes, definitely that's something that's, I think, high on our list of things that we need to work on, is making sure we see some pitching with some speed and try to get some live at-bats and try to get ourselves, you know, grooving a little bit better at the plate.
And definitely not having as many practices as, of course, yeah, Thursday, Friday, Monday in the games. And you actually have four games this week as well. Does that affect how you approach any of the games at all?
You know, this early in the season, I think it gives us a chance to give some kids some at-bats and see, you know, who's going to have some success and try to kind of start working on maybe finding a consistent lineup for us. But, you know, that's what these first two weeks, especially this week with, you know, like you said, four games. And then next week we have three games. So, you know, trying to maybe come out of these next 2 weeks with a lineup that we like, you know, that we kind of start sticking with a little bit.
And coming up now, another home game for you against Sioux Falls Roosevelt. What do you hope to see your team do well in this one?
You know, I think we need to just, you know, start working in, you know, a positive direction and at the plate, you know, finding good pitches to swing at and make some good solid contact. And then I think, you know, for our pitchers, just hit a reset button and start working on trying to hit spots and throwing, you know, the pitches that we had been the first night for strikes, just keep working on throwing those for strikes and seeing if we can then make plays behind them in the defense.
And we could see a little moisture on the fields, as rain definitely a possibility for today. Has your team gotten a lot of opportunities to field with these conditions?
No, not a whole lot. You know, when it was wet so far this year, we've been mostly inside. But the nice thing is we play on turf, so it's not going to at least be a muddy mess for us. So hopefully that will make, you know, won't be too bad.
And one thing I want to point out, as we've talked about the bats a little bit, in the first game it was kind of Churchma had the good game at the plate. On Friday, mm-hmm. then was Mosier. She went 2-for-2 in the game, a couple of solid hits. You know, is there anyone on your team as far as batting that you're kind of just waiting? It's going to happen any time now with that, you know, that boom at the plate?
Yeah, you know, I think the leading hitter that we had back was Cam Kolecki. So I think Cameron's, you know, going to get to a point where she's ready to, you know, kind of start taking some, or having some good at-bats and being a leader for us at the plate. So I think just those three names, you know, those two names you said, and then add Cameron Kolecki to that list too.
And now I do have to ask, have there been any kind of surprises as far as the performances in play from once you first saw your team first practice to now?
I've been really happy with our pitchers, you know, that just coming in with that question mark. And I think that first game against Brandon, throwing good game for us and just thinking that that's a spot that they can be in. And as we keep going and getting them more experience, I think that's going to be good for them. So I've been happy with them.
Again, thanks for the time, Coach. Another game of softball. Good luck tonight.
All right. Thanks, Zach. Thanks for your coverage.
Again, that was Jill Muth, head coach of the Yankton Gazelles. We'll be back in a moment for the matchup between Yankton and Sioux Falls Roosevelt on 5-Star Streaming on YouTube.
Angel Crossing, located at 1101 Broadway Morgan Square in Yankton. Hi, it's Linda. Welcome to my store. The girls' department is sizes 2T to 14. The nursery holds Copper Pearl, Little Me Sleepers. The boys' department is 2T to 12. There's retro toys and little golden books. The ladies' department holds Tribal and Jag and Lulu B and jewelry and purses and your Yankton High School colors. Thank you for shopping Linda's Angel Crossing.
If you've fallen behind on your do-it-yourself projects at home and don't know where to start, Mead Lumber is your answer. Mead Lumber is your local stop for all things home improvement, from cabinetry to roofing. We have what you need for your next project. For over 100 years, Mead Lumber has been assisting customers with their home improvement needs, as well as assisting professional contractors, builders, and remodelers. The knowledgeable staff at Mead Lumber of Yankton will help you finish all your projects. Located at 2409 North Broadway, stop in today to see how Mead Lumber can help you.
Insurance Agency values family. Our agency has been family run for over 60 years. We pride ourselves on excellent, knowledgeable customer service. This day and age, everyone is so eager to have an immediate response with a quote. But at Midwest Insurance, we take our time and evaluate your assets and make sure you are properly insured. We take those what ifs very seriously. As we continue on our family business with hopes of our children, Brooke or Jet, taking over in the future, we will continue to be there for you always. Come be a part of our family. Midwest Insurance Agency, 3016 Piper Street, Yankton.
The Riverfront and Brewery Event Centers and Hotels Yankton has choices for a bride and groom and your wedding reception. Different spaces are available for your wedding reception, and the price is very competitive. Have your wedding reception where they offer you plenty of time for the decorating you and your family want to do, and plenty of time for cleanup, too. At the Riverfront and Brewery Event Centers and Hotels, you have 2.5-day venue that's all yours. See more by cruising the website, Riverfront and Brewery Event Centers and Hotels.
As they've just announced the starting lineups here on the field, I'll get to that as well. As we have the national anthem coming up, we'll keep it here.
Please stand, remove your caps or hats, and place your right hand over your heart for the playing of our national anthem. All veterans and out-of-uniform military personnel may salute the flag. The flag is located behind the home plate bleachers.
We wash, we're so gallantly. Gazelle fans, let's get ready to play ball.
Again, you just heard the national anthem played here at Sertoma Park in Yankton, South Dakota. Now for your Larry's Heating and Cooling of Yankton and Vermilion starting lineups for all your HVAC needs. It's Larry's Heating and Cooling anytime, any day. First for the visiting team, they'll be up to the plate first. Number three leadoff center fielder, Kylie Reisenweber. She's followed by catcher number 29, Kaylee Drew. In the three spot on the mound, wearing number 23, it's Desiree Hinch. In the cleanup spot for the Rough Riders, third baseman, number 54, Carly Felsheim. In the five spot, designated hitter, number 44, Aaliyah Chigola. She is batting in place of number 29, left fielder, Lauren Carlson. In the six spot, shortstop, number 5, Raylan Sealer. In the seven spot, number 4, right fielder, Abigail Paulson. Second baseman, number 9, Mackenzie Johnson in the 8th spot. And to round up the lineup for the Rough Riders, number 25 at first base, it's Peyton Eckline. As the Gazelles take to the field first, we'll get our batting lineup in a moment. But first, let's set the field. In center field, it's Emma Iacker with Cameron Koletsky alongside her in left field. And next to her, Haley Schulte in right field. At shortstop, Kyra Churchma behind the mound. Behind the plate will be Peyton Mosier with Tori Hansen starting on the mound. At first, Emma Herbolt, the usual. Madison Gerard at third. Madison Musfelt will be hitting in place of Tori Hansen. And to round up the Gazelles field, second base, Chase Drotzman. Top of the first inning, just about ready to get started. We wrapped up our Yankton Medical Clinic pregame show. So much care, so close to home. And all Yankton athletics are brought to you by First Dakota National Bank of Yankton. First Dakota has proudly supported the dreams and banking needs of their customers for over 150 years. They offer personal, business, and ag banking solutions for every stage of your journey with two locations, downtown and North Broadway, Yankton. Well, this game just about ready to get started. Hansen with the first pitch. It's high, misses for a ball. Again, it's Kylie Reisenweber at the plate here for the Rough Riders. Trying to get things started here. Gazelles looking to get that first win here on the season. Hansen winds up, fires. A good pitch. That one's hit into shallow left field. Koletsky is able to track it down, pull it in for out number one here in the top of the first inning. That was one that could have been trouble between shortstop and left field, but Koletsky, a very good outfielder. She played it last year on varsity as well, able to run in and bring it down. So Reisenweber starts with a fly out to left field. Kaylee Drew now at the plate for Sioux Falls Roosevelt, a lefty here for the Rough Riders. That pitch just misses high. Drew looked like she thought about swinging. Held off. 1-0 is the count. Hansen likes the pitch call. Fires it. She's going to get a piece of Drew. Drew heading now to first. She's hit by the pitch, and the first base runner of the game will be for the Rough Riders. Again, Kaylee Drew standing on first now with a bean. Desiree Hinch at the plate. First pitcher's duel of the game. We'll probably see quite a few here. Hansen now has to deal with the batter with a runner on, as that one's a line drive hit into left field. Picked up by Koletsky, but it did bounce, and that will be a base hit for Desiree Hinch standing on first. The first base hit here of the game. Kaylee Drew now on second with Hinch on first. One out here. As looks like Coach Seitz talking with the umpire. As we do have a pinch runner for Sioux Falls Roosevelt. It's going to be number 15, Ella Storer. As that pitch low and inside misses, Mosier able to keep it in front of her though. Gazelles looking to avoid giving up runs here in the top of the first. So far, the Rough Riders have put the ball in play. when given the opportunity. As that one's a line drive, scooped up at third. Third is touched for the first out, and at first, a double play. As Carly Felsheim hits into a double play. Madison Girard with the big play there. A line shot on the ground, but no matter what, she's able to pick it up. Touch third, send it over to first for the double play. Four up, three down for the Rough Riders. When we return, it's the bottom of the first, and we'll see how the Gazelles' bats are rolling early in the game.
You deserve to get good service and great rates. At State Farm, we get it, and we're here to help. Because with every State Farm policy, you get good neighbor service and surprisingly great rates. So what are you waiting for? Get going and talk to a local State Farm agent about your surprisingly great rates today. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. Individual premiums will vary by customer. All applicants subject to State Farm underwriting requirements. When you want the real deal, call State Farm agent Roy Wilcox in Yankton today.
Are you looking for your next great career opportunity? Then make it Sherco, a staple of the Yankton community. Sherco offers career opportunities in engineering, sales, marketing, accounting, tarp, metal fabrication, shipping, and assembly. Enjoy a year-round climate-controlled facility, 401k options, affordable health, dental, and vision care, paid time off, and 10 paid holidays. Make Sherco your next great opportunity. Learn more at sherco.com/careers.
Back here for the bottom of the first inning. Now a chance to hear your Gazelles batting lineup. Leading off, number 17, Emma Iacker. She's followed by 20, Cameron Koletsky. In the hole, Kyra Churchma at shortstop. And the cleanup spot, Peyton Mosier, who's been behind the plate to start. At first, Emma Herbolt in the five spot. Madison Girard coming off that double play will be batting sixth. In the seventh spot, Madison Musfeldt hitting for Tori Hansen. Chase Drotzman in the eighth spot. And for the ninth spot to round off the Gazelles batting lineup, Haley Schulte. First pitch against Iacker called for a ball. Next one on the way. That one finds a strike zone, evens up the count, 1-1. Desiree Hinch on the mound here for the Rough Riders. Hinch, that one, Iacker kind of took a half swing at it, missed it, 1-2 now the count. Behind the plate, Kaylee Drew. Next pitch on the way. Just barely misses outside, 2-2. Now that's a tough one to hold off on, but the right call by Iacker. Swing and a miss there for Iacker as Sioux Falls Roosevelt starts their defensive efforts with a strikeout. Now Cameron Koletsky for the first time of the day. Koletsky was one that Muth had mentioned really a good batter, just hasn't quite gotten things rolling here, but you expect her one of these games it's going to click and she's going to have multiple base hits in the game. First pitch looked like it missed high, 1-0. No runners on, one out here for the Gazelles. Koletsky got a piece of that one straight back into the backstop, 1-1. On deck, Kyra Churchma with Peyton Mosier in the hole now. Sounds like runs, as they always said in the dugout. Hinch's next pitch inside and low for another ball, 2-1. As Drew trying to do her best framework behind the plate here. As Koletsky watches that one, misses again, 3-1. So Koletsky now has the choice to be a little picky here on this pitch. Hinch, the windup, she fouls that one off. Knotted up at a full count now, 3-2. Cameron Koletsky has seen a handful here of full counts on the season now. We'll see what happens here as Hinch winds up. As inside, Cameron Koletsky's headed to first with a walk as the first base runner of the day for the Gazelles. Now Kyra Churchma batting, has a runner on first. Peyton Mosier takes off her shin guards as she's the catcher, but more likely than not, barring a double play, will bat this inning. Hinch, Churchma takes the first pitch, called for a strike right down the pipe. Hinch, awaiting Churchman to get in the box. She's set. The pitch. Churchma's going to follow that one out of play. Counts now 0-2, as you can hear. Maybe not as windy as this weekend was for baseball, but still some good gusts blowing in directly from left field. So if somebody hits it over the fence in left field, just know they hit that ball awfully hard. 0-2 the count. Churchma fighting. She's fouled it off. Hinch, the next pitch, as that one's inside, reaches the backstop. Koletsky to second. Slides, maybe didn't need to, but either way, she's standing on second in scoring position here if Churchma has the right base hit. First pitch in the game was brought to you by the Move Group of Yankton. That pitch just misses outside, so Churchma forcing Hinch to throw to her. 2-2 now the count. Next pitch on the way. Churchma lines it right back up the middle. Caught. Good contact from Churchma. Wrong position as Desiree Hinch sticks out her glove, snags it for out number two. Peyton Mosier up to the plate. So Mosier now at the plate. Takes the first pitch, just barely misses inside, 1-0. Peyton here. Peyton Mosier coming off a hot game. She was 2-for-2 against Harrisburg. Trying to replicate that performance here. Next pitch is low and inside for ball two. On deck, Emma Herbolt. As Hinch tries to put the first inning away. That one getting back to the backstop. Koletsky takes off for third. She's there safe. So ball three, 3-0 the count. If Mosier could just poke one out in the outfield, Cameron Koletsky would easily score. Koletsky was walked earlier, trying to be the first score of this game. That's in for a strike. No swing for Mosier. Was a 3-0 count. I mean, got, as they say, it's got to be perfect on a 3-0 count. Next pitch, as Mosier now heading to first with another walk here in the game. So runners on first and third with Emma Herbolt now. Has two runners on. Two outs, though. Base hit here would be huge for the Gazelles and give them the first lead of the game. First pitch is good. Taking off for second is Mosier. She'll be there without a throwdown. So Gazelle's really good position here to score. But again, those two outs could be an issue. Herbolt's going to crack that one high up into center field. And it's going to be brought down. So no runs scored here for the Gazelles. That one's brought down by Kylie Reisenweber in center field. Tracking it. Wind didn't look to affect it too much. But either way, after one full inning of play, we are still knotted up. No score here. Gazelles to take the field when we return on 5-Star Streaming on YouTube.
Visit our sleep experts at the Yankton Slumberland. With over 50 mattresses to choose from, we carry every price, free financing options, and the most trusted brands in the nation like Stearns & Foster, Sealy, and Tempur-Pedic. Snoring or lower back pain tormenting you? Seek relief with an adjustable power base. Fall asleep faster and cooler with our sheets and pillow selection. With a 120-night sleep trial, you can't make a mistake. See us today at the Yankton Slumberland, 2401 Broadway.
Doctors Lane and Reed Sawatsky make up the team at SWAT Chiropractic and Rehab. Located at 800 Mariner Lane on the way out to the lake, we combine chiropractic with soft tissue treatments and rehabilitative exercise to custom tailor each individual patient experience. From sports injuries to sciatic nerve pain, we are here to help you move better and get back to doing what you love. SWAT Chiropractic, specialized wellness and therapy.
Back here, top of the second inning here, Sioux Falls Roosevelt Rough Riders. Leading off is Aaliyah Chigola. She's followed by Raylan Sealer and Abigail Paulson in the hole. Throw down from Mosier. As that one gets into center field. No score here. One base hit total in the game. It belongs to the Rough Riders. And Desiree Hinch, specifically, who's also been on the mound, did a good job there in that first inning. As Hansen now on the mound comes back to work. Chigola hitting in place of Lauren Carlson, the left fielder. Hansen winds up, fires it. Chigola got a piece of that one sky high in the infield, tracking it down as a somewhat of a collision. Hansen and Herbert ran into each other. An error by the Gazelles as Chigola standing on first. And looked like Hansen had that one, and kind of last second, her and Herbert ran into each other. You know, from here, I didn't really hear anyone calling it out, but it did appear to be closest to Hansen. But on the other hand, Herbert's running in, so that's when you really need that communication of who's got it, and you make sure they got it, get out of the way. So that brings up Raylan Sealer, Abigail Paulson on deck here. First pitch hits the outside zone, strike one. And that's something we saw in the first game, the Gazelles, two total errors, a very clean game. Against Harrisburg, they had two errors in the four innings of play. They have one here early. We'll see if they can pick up that aspect. As that one bounces, as I think it did get a piece of Sealer. Sealer's heading to first, and as a batter, that's got to be the best way to get hit by a pitch, is off of a bounce. It loses so much of the momentum. That, or quite honestly, the helmet's not as bad. Abigail Paulson here. Another lefty for the Rough Riders, has runners on first and second here. She's the seventh batter in her lineup, showing signs of bunt, pulls back. As they're going to say she did go for it, 0-1. And that's kind of when you get into the discussion, is it a bunt? Are we going for a slap hit here? So Hansen with some work to do here on defense. She's going to fire away, and a bunt does get put down. It goes foul on the third baseline. So 0-2 now the count, as Paulson probably not going to be attempting a bunt here, as anything fouled off would then be ruled as an out. But after two bunt attempts, 0-2 the count. Hansen a chance to get the first out herself, as we do have a bunt attempt. It gets put down. It's foul. That's going to be an out. Pretty surprised to see the bunt attempt with two strikes. Or am I mistaken? Is that a difference between baseball and softball? I'm getting confused here. Count stays at 0-2, I believe. Another fouled off bunt attempt. As now they're going to call an out. I'm not quite sure if. So that will be ruled as a strikeout. I wonder if I had the strikes. Maybe one of them was. Maybe they, on that first pitch, they did call it a ball. Either way, it will be an out. One down here. First pitch is called for a strike against Mackenzie Johnson at the plate, as Hansen has found a rhythm on the mound here. And again, I think the mistake was made. I think they said she maybe pulled back on that first bunt attempt. I had thought it as a strike, and it was shown a strike here on the scoreboard, but it must not have been. As that one's cracked into right field, Schulte getting under it. She does make the grab, taking off for third are the Rough Riders. They'll make it. So runners on first and third, but Haley Schulte catches the pop fly from Mackenzie Johnson for out number two. Peyton Eckline now at the plate. Two outs, runners on first and third. Now the Rough Riders try to be the first ones to score in this. Last inning with runners on first and second and one out, the Gazelles were able to get out of a sticky situation. We'll see here if they can do it again. They'll take off for second. They'll get it. No throw down from Mosier. They'll just let them take second. So runners now on second and third. On third is a pinch runner. As I try to get the number quick. Next pitch. That one's fouled off. It's going to be out of play. That one would have been well high, but counts now 1-1. As I'm seeing number 24, that is not a number I actually have on my roster. So all we know, a pinch runner on third. On second is Raylan Sealer. The 1-1 pitch misses outside, 2-1. Peyton Eckline. One swing from her was fouled off. We'll see if she can put it in play for her team here. That one misses outside zone again. Now 3-1, as you wonder, that one pitch that Eckline did swing at was pretty high. If she had left that one alone, she could be standing on first here with a walk. But Hansen still in this as Yankton works on defense. Next pitch, a swing and a ground ball. Herbolt picks it up. It's a race for first as she tags Eckline out as, again, Yankton avoids giving up any runs, playing very tough defense when it matters most. Heading into the bottom of the second inning, leading off for the Gazelles will be Madison Girard when we return on 5-Star Streaming on YouTube.
Looking for your first home? How about your next home? Maybe a vacation home. The Move Group is a full-service real estate brokerage operating in South Dakota, primarily servicing the Yankton and Sioux Falls, South Dakota areas. Having the knowledge and the drive to help you make the right purchase to suit you and your needs. When buying or selling a home, Mason at The Move Group is ready to get you the results you are looking for. Call us today. We're ready to work for you. Make the move with The Move Group.
Here at Sertoma Park, a little chilly. We've got a breeze, but that's no problem. We'll be here for the entirety of the game. Again, Yankton Gazelles looking to add a number in that win column here on the season. Two very tough games. Brandon Valley was a close game, and then they took on a Harrisburg who was just ready to roll. And as I'd mentioned, pretty much anything you put in front of them, they were going to be hitting. That is one of the better softball teams I've seen in quite some time. So bottom of the second inning. Leading off, it's Madison Girard. She's followed by Madison Musfelt on deck and Chase Drotzman in the hole. So Desiree Hinch still on the mound here as Jill Muth with some kind of sub telling the umpire about, but it looks like it's Girard and Musfelt, so we'll await to see who it is, if anyone, now with these jackets on top. First pitch finds its way to the strike zone. But again, with these jackets on top, with some of the players, like for Sioux Falls Roosevelt, makes it a little tougher to decipher who's who. Next pitch, Girard got a piece of that one off of Drew's helmet behind the plate. 0-2 the count. That's why they say, got to be tough to play catcher. Next pitch on the way. Swing and a miss. Girard goes down with a strikeout. That'll bring up Madison Musfelt. On deck, Chase Drotzman and Haley Schulte in the hole. Schulte brings some speed there in the bottom end of the lineup. As a bunt attempt here, that one's fouled straight back into the net. It'll be a strike. Oh, on the count, one out. No runners on here. At the plate, Madison Musfelt. Swing and a miss there from Musfelt. Oh, 2 the count now. Hinch so far on the mound making quick work of this inning, and she'll keep it up with another strikeout here. Musfeldt can't get a piece of that one. Two straight strikeouts. That'll bring up Chase Drotzman. No runners on. Drotzman at the plate. Has no runners on for her. She takes a cut, doesn't get it. 0-1 the count here. Hinch winds up, fires it. Drotzman fouls that one off. Dead ball as it hits the net. 0-2 now. So Hinch, I believe, if she strikes out Drotzman on this pitch, I believe that is a 9-pitch inning. Very hard to achieve. Next pitch is high, misses for a ball. So we'll have to wait on the 9-pitch inning. Maybe we'll see it from Tori Hansen in the next half. Drotzman awaiting the next pitch, as that one misses just outside. 2-2 now the count. Deuces wild. Two balls, two strikes, two outs, second inning. Chase Drotzman, the second baseman, as that one misses inside and low. Now the count all of a sudden full for Drotzman, working her way back into this at-bat. Something you love to see from your batters is, even though you're down 0-2, you don't have to swing at everything. As Drotzman lined that one foul down the first baseline, she's making some contact here. Just needs to get it straightened out. That would have been a nice base hit into right field had it been straighter. Haley Schulte still awaits on deck. As Drotzman gets her next pitch, it's called for strike three. So three up, three down for the Gazelles. All three strikeouts at the hand of Desiree Hinch. Again, Hinch off to a hot start. She has a base hit in the game. And already four of the six outs for Yankton have been strikeouts at the hands of Hinch. When we return, Rough Riders, top of the third inning on Five Star Streaming on YouTube.
Hi, this is Clay.
And Rachel.
From the Red Hydrant Inn and Playground in Yankton.
We offer daycare, boarding, grooming, and training for all breeds of dogs.
We are the one-stop shop for all dog necessities. Treats, toys, collars, leashes, and more.
Your dog is family, and we treat them like our own.
Give us a call at 665-7297 or stop in 2901 Broadway in Yankton. We can't wait to meet you and your pet. Again, 665-7297.
Make it a double. No, make it a triple. Triple Time Rudy's in Yankton. Stop for premium, ethanol, or regular gas anytime with pay at the pump. Or stop in during regular hours to find the meats, cheeses, beverages, snacks to fuel you up. There's oil, grease, and more for your vehicles, gift cards, an unbeatable staff, and just the right amount of that personal service. Make it a Triple Time Rudy's, corner of 17th and Broadway, Yankton.
Back just in time for the first pitch in the top of the third. Leading off, Kylie Reisenweber here for the Rough Riders. First pitch from Hansen, misses for a ball. Reisenweber flew out in her first at-bat in the first inning. Gets a second opportunity here now in the third. As that pitch misses outside, ball two. On deck for the Rough Riders, Kaylee Drew. As the next pitch for Reisenweber, outside. 3-0 now the count. Three balls, no strikes here. Gazelles trying to get that first out. They do find the outside zone on that pitch from Hansen. Three balls, one strike now. Reisenweber made a catch out earlier in center field. As takes that pitch for ball four. She's headed to first, she's walked. And again, the Rough Riders with a base runner. Kaylee Drew steps up to the plate, her second at bat. She was beaned in the first inning, was thrown out at third off of the hard-hit grounder that Girard was able to pick up, make a good double play off of. But Drew at the plate now, Desiree Hinch on deck, and Carly Felsheim in the hole. First pitch, Drew lofts that one into right field, drifting as it's going to barely miss, foul. That's one as a batter that kind of stings. You watch it, would have. It's a guaranteed base hit, essentially. Watching it just barely drift, foul. I mean, that couldn't have missed by more than 6 inches there. Either way, 0-1 the count here. Drew will have to try and do it again. Ryzen Weber still on first. As that pitch misses inside. One ball, one strike. Both teams cheering each other on from their dugouts. And in the field for the Gazelles as a hard hit grounder up the middle gets through, a base hit here for the Rough Riders. Ryzen Weber heading for third. She's going to be safe. Runners on first and third after a Kaylee Drew single. Has her on first. Two base hits in the game, both belonging to the Rough Riders so far. That brings up Desiree Hinch. She's 1-for-1 on the day, hit a single in the first inning. Felsheim on deck and Chagola in the hole. Hansen in the Gazelles. That one's fouled off, well out of play. But Hansen and the Gazelles with a little uphill work to do here, trying to go 3 innings of play without giving up a run. But a runner on third with no outs could prove to be difficult. Hinch, no swing there, but it's called for a strike. 0-2 now. As Kaylee Drew trying to get Mosier to fire the ball down. Maybe getting a pickle so that he can send Ryzen Weber home, score that run. An out is worth a run, especially in a tie ball game. 0-2 now the count. As that one's fouled off as all of a sudden feeling a few raindrops here. As we'll make sure, send Gage out to get the blanket in case it's necessary to save the equipment. 0-2 the count, though. Hinch at the plate. Runners on first and third for her. Hansen on the mound. Winds up, fires it. A grounder to Girard at third. Gets through as Rough Riders score first. They've got one on the board now. An error by the Gazelles. Now 2 in the game for them. As the score is now 1-0. Ryzen Weber scores. Kaylee Drew to second. Desiree Hinch at first off the error. And now at the plate, Carly Felsheim. Again on our Fox Stop scoreboard. Yankton trails 1-0 here in the top of the third inning. No outs. Hansen, a grounder right back up the middle. Another base hit here for the Rough Riders. They'll send home as they're looking to score a second run. They'll do so. Base hit there from Felsheim. Advances Kaylee Drew all the way from second home. Desiree Hinch to second, and on first now is Felsheim. So 3 base hits here for the Rough Riders. Next pitch. Misses inside for a ball. It's against Aaliyah Chagola at the plate. Chagola did reach on error, but 0-for-1 technically for the day. As that one's launched up backwards out of play. Luckily not too near my car. So 1 ball, 1 strike here. Chagola at the plate. Sioux Falls Roosevelt has scored two runs here in the top of the third inning, led off by Reisenweber. As that pitch does find the strike zone, one ball, two strikes now. So Gazelle's really needing that first out, and again, sometimes just getting that first out is all you need. 1-2 here. Aaliyah Chagula awaits the next pitch on its way as she fouls that one straight back. So count stays 1-2. Still no outs and runners on first and second here. Hansen trying to take this one herself. Would be huge if she can get a strikeout here for Yankton. That pitch low in the dirt, but caught by Mosier. Make sure neither run. 2-2 now the count. Chagula, the fifth batter in the starting lineup and the fifth batter to hit this inning for Sioux Falls Roosevelt. As that one's fouled off, hits the backstop. Count still stays 2-2. Few foul balls here from the Rough Riders. Two balls, two strikes, no outs. Runners on first and second. Hansen on the mound. She'll wind up and fire. Swing and a miss. Chagula goes down with a strikeout as Hansen gets her team a much-needed out. And what a battle at the plate it was. Multiple foul balls when there was already two strikes, but Hansen able to work through it, keep firing strikes. She gets the first one herself. Now Raylan Sealer at the plate here for the Rough Riders. Sealer was hit earlier in the game by a pitch. Takes the first pitch for a strike. 0-1. No balls, one strike. Sealer gets a piece of that one. A dribbler over to third. Picked up and touching third. But Girard unable to get the double play again as it pops out of Herbolt's glove. And now looks like the Rough Riders trying to send for home. The throw doesn't make it. They'll score. So Sealer on by fielder's choice as Desiree Hinch is out number two at third, and Felshine makes it all the way home off of the Gazelle's error. So now three errors in the game for Yankton. As a bunt does get down, a drift foul though from Paulson. Abigail Paulson again at the plate with Mackenzie Johnson on deck. Score now 3-0. Two outs here. As Hansen fires that. Misses outside. The next pitch. Paulson got a piece of it. Fouled on the third baseline. It looked like Coach Seitz may be running into that one, wanted to get hit. That'll make it one ball, two strikes. In the top of the third inning, 1-2 the count. Two outs. As that pitch well high. Paulson facing now a 2-2 count. As she has one runner on first and Sealer. As that one a swing and a miss. Tori Hansen going to take two of the three herself with two strikeouts. Add to her season total as the Gazelles now with some work to do at the plate. They trail 3-0. We'll see if they can mount a comeback, get some of those runs back in a moment on 5 Star Streaming on YouTube.
Are you looking for a cool place to work? Look no further than Tuxedo. Not only does Tuxedo have a cool, positive, and people-oriented culture, but the building is climate controlled too. Check out the many job opportunities at Tuxedo. They're looking for a receiving supervisor, weekend production supervisor, weeknight shipping clerk, and weekday and weekend production positions. Apply at realtruck.com/careers. Tuxedo of Yankton. Working for a successful global business with customers in 140 countries. That's Vishay Intertechnology, a Fortune 1000 maker of electronic componentry. Now imagine a company of that size with that kind of stability and a caring family-like environment. Learn more about what you can do at Vishay by visiting VishayCareers.com. Vishay is an equal opportunity employer. Vishay, the DNA of tech.
2.5 innings of play done with. Now Haley Schulte bats for the first time here for the Gazelles. Bottom of the third. They trail 3-0. Emma Iacker on deck with Koletsky in the hole. As Schulte got a piece of that one. Straight back, 0-1 the count. A left-handed hitter here for Yankton. Schulte takes the next pitch. It's outside for a ball. 1-1. No runners on. Hinch, next pitch, is good for a strike. No swing there. One ball, two strikes here. Schulte's next pitch. Did she go? As they're going to say, she did swing, so strike three. Schulte goes down. That's four straight batters retired by strikeout from Desiree Hinch on the mound. She has got her rhythm going here. Emma Iacker at the plate. She's 0 for 1 today. She struck out as the first batter here for the Gazelles. First pitch is inside for a ball. Koletsky on deck. As Gazelle's still looking for that first base hit here of the game. Just need to break the ice. That pitch high for ball two. Next pitch on the way. As Iacker fouls that one straight back. Now two balls, one strike. Kaylee Drew having to go get a lot at the backstop here. Hinch, the next pitch. Just a touch outside. 3-1. Gazelles need base runners. They'll take it any way they can. As that pitch. Well, Iacker almost fooled me to say. She almost fooled me with the head over to first. It's called for a strike. Now count full, 3-2. Next pitch on the way. Iacker is going to foul that one back into the backstop again. And she sold that one well, so convincingly that, oh yeah, that's ball four. I was already calling it. The umpire said, not so fast. Hinch, the next pitch on the way. Iacker, that one hit up as Kaylee drew a diving effort, unable to bring it down. Iacker is going to stay alive at least for one more pitch for this at bat. So a couple of foul balls here for Iacker, trying to time out Desiree Hinch on the mound. As she takes that one inside, and this time she will be able to take first with a walk. A close pitch though. I wasn't saying anything. Cameron Koletsky at the plate now, followed by Kyra Churchma on deck. Koletsky was walked in the first, made her way around to third, was left on base, though, alongside Mosier, who was on second. But Koletsky has a runner on, takes the first pitch, hits the outside zone. One, two, I don't know, it didn't look like Koletsky agreed with that call. 0-1, though, with one out, runner on first. Koletsky takes that for strike two. Now it's 0-2, can't be picky. The 0-2 pitch, Koletsky swings, she got a piece of it, but it's caught by Kaylee Drew. It'll count as a strikeout for Koletsky. Two down, Kyra Churchma at the plate. Kyra Churchma is 0-for-1 today. Grounded out in the first inning. Right back up to Hinch. Excuse me, that was the line drive. First pitch taken for a strike. That was a line drive hitting right back up to Hinch. And pretty much anywhere else you can get a base hit unless it's right where the defender is currently standing. That's exactly what it was. Good contact nonetheless. The next pitch on the way. Churchma gets a piece of that straight back into the backstop. Nearly going over the net. Luckily, I think we're pretty safe where we are sitting. I can't imagine too many instances where it's going to come down and hit us. 0-2 now the count. Hinch fires as Churchma. Same result. High off the back net. Another foul ball. Peyton Mosier waits on deck with her shin guard still on. As that one misses outside. Drew will pump fake down to first, forcing Iacker to head back. Next pitch as Churchma got a good piece of that one, but well foul, well out of play. A little behind Hinch's pitching right now, but making contact with every swing here. So Churchma still facing now a 1-2 count as she'll take that one inside. That's a little closer than I'd care to take on a two-strike pitch, but called a ball. Churchma, good call. As she's going to hit that one, a pop-up to third base as it's caught by Carly Felsheim. That will retire the third inning entirely. Rough Riders still on top, 3-0. When we return, leading off for the Rough Riders, Mackenzie Johnson on 5-Star Streaming on YouTube.
Simple sniffles to complex health conditions, the primary care providers at Yankton Medical Clinic will not only see you for your annual visits, screenings, and preventative care, but also provides care for the entire family, from pediatrics to adults. With 4 clinic locations and 15 outreach locations throughout South Dakota and Nebraska, compassionate, quality medical care is closer than you think. For more information on providers, services, and locations, visit our website, yanktonmedicalclinic.com.
Yankton Rexall, located in the Meridian District, downtown Yankton, has Hallmark cards and keepsake ornaments. They carry many different items for that wedding, anniversary, or special birthday, along with collectibles like Precious Moments and Willow Tree. The pharmacy is home to the ever-popular Med Packs, and the toy store offers Melissa and Doug toys, Abdallah chocolates, and Sweet Shop candy. When you want something perfect for gift giving, find it at Yankton Rexall in the Meridian District on 3rd Street.
After 3 innings on our Fox Stop scoreboard, Sioux Falls Roosevelt leading Yankton 3-0. Leading off for the Rough Riders, number 9, the 8th batter in the lineup, Mackenzie Johnson. She'll be followed by Peyton Eckline on deck with Ryzen Weber. In the hole, she'll have her 3rd at-bat here in 4 innings. Johnson 0-for-1 today. Hit it to right field. Haley Schulte was able to come down with it. That was the second out of the second inning. First pitch misses outside from Hansen, who's still on the mound here. One 0 the count. As that pitch high from Hansen, now 2-0 make it. Hansen winds up Fires another one. That one's driven into right field again. This time it's going to land, though. Haley Schulte will scoop it up, but a single hit by Mackenzie Johnson. That is the fourth base hit here of the game for the Rough Riders. Peyton Eckline at the plate. She's 0 for 1, grounded out in the second inning. Ryzen Weber on deck with Kaylee Drew now in the hole. So the ninth batter here in Eckline takes the first pitch inside. It's a ball. No outs here. Runner on first. That's Johnson after the leadoff single. That pitch misses outside. 2-0. Next pitch on the way as it's hit right back to Hansen. Now that one off the bat looked like it was maybe going to go to the outfield. All of a sudden it's still right in front of Hansen. She's able to catch it for out number one. So Ryzen Weber at the plate now. She is 0 for 1, was also walked in the third inning. On deck, Kaylee Drew. Kaylee Drew is 1 for 1. Base hit, also got hit by a pitch, so her on base percentage 1,000 right now in the game. The windup, good pitch from Hansen there, 0-1 now. As it looks like the scoreboard out in the outfield hasn't there, they're going to correct it. Hansen, the next pitch, a hard hit grounder, that's making it to center field. Another base hit for the Rough Riders. They'll have runners on first and second here. Mackenzie Johnson on second. Ryzen Weber on first with a single. As now five base hits in the game here for Sioux Falls Roosevelt. Still one out. Runners on first and second here. Kaylee Drew at the plate. Desiree Hinch will be on deck. Gazelles again in a tricky situation trying to avoid giving up any runs. Hansen winds up, gets that one in the strike zone, 0-1. The 0-1 pitch as a grounder hit right back to Herbolt, touches first, gets the second out. She's going to hang on to it. Didn't have an opportunity to get anyone else, but two outs now here. Mackenzie Johnson advances to third. Kylie Ryzenweber now to second. And again, Kaylee Drew is going to ground out to first for the second out. Desiree Hinch at the plate. She's reached base both times, once off an error, once off of a single she hit in the first inning. But her runners on second and third. Hard hit grounder right back at her third base coach. Got some power on that one, but fouled off, so 0-1. No balls, one strike, two outs. Runners on second and third. As a line drive shot into left field, Koletsky can't make the diving grab. Instead, it'll be a base hit here for Sioux Falls Roosevelt. Scoring two, standing on second now will be Desiree Hinch. Ryzen Weber scores, Mackenzie Johnson scores. And another base hit here for the Rough Riders. They're now up to six hits in the game. So now a runner on second here. Has a line drive cracked right up the middle. Sioux Falls Roosevelt sending them, trying to score again. The throw doesn't make it in time. Make it 6-0. As Carly Felsheim, two big base hits already. Two singles for her. As Leah Chigola bats here. She's 0 for 2, but she did reach by error in the second inning. Four base hits in the inning for the Rough Riders. Again, making it 6-0 on her Fox Top scoreboard. A grounder there, picked up by Girard. The throw makes it, as that will put away the Rough Riders here in the top of the fourth inning, but not before they were able to tag on three more runs, making this a 6-0 game. When we return, Yankton Gazelles batting up first, Peyton Mosier on 5-Star Streaming on YouTube.
Fight the wait when your furnace and AC needs repair by joining Larry's Heating and Cooling, Comfort Care, and Elite Care Club. Larry's Comfort Care Club features seasonal maintenance discounts on service and no overtime charges. Larry's Elite Club includes seasonal maintenance, free parts, free labor, free service calls, and both mean you are in front of the line for service. Call Larry's Heating and Cooling and sign up for the Comfort Care or Elite Care Club. Larry's Heating and Cooling, Yankton and Vermilion.
Maytag appreciates a compliment, but this Maytag washer isn't just eye candy.
Wow.
Inside, it's got the capacity and power to handle even the mightiest loads.
I love this.
Yeah, she's a beaut.
It's a he.
How do you know?
Don't worry about it.
Find Maytag products and the industry's best appliances at your local dealer, Murph's Appliance, downtown Vermilion.
Bottom of the fourth inning, Peyton Mosier to lead off here for the Gazelles. Again, Gazelles with 6 runs to catch up on here. Now, the scoreboard in the field says 5. I'm pretty confident it is 6-0. And now it has been changed. The umpire made sure to let him know what the score is. Now, the Gazelles, of course, wouldn't have minded it being 5-0 instead of 6. Either way, they have got some work to do. Peyton Mosier steps into the box to face Hinch again. Takes the first pitch, just barely misses inside. 1-0 now the count. Herbolt on deck with Madison Girard in the hole. Mosier fouls that one off. She was walked in the first inning, reached second before she was left stranded. Hinch, that pitch outside, counts 2-1. As Mosier did foul that one straight back. As that one crosses the plate high. 3-1 here. Mosier has the option to be picky here. As she does take that strike, she was ready to head off her first. Counts now full, 3-2. Mosier no longer availability to be picky, but no swing there as that one's in the dirt. Turf, I should say. Mosier standing on first with a walk. Emma Herbolt now batting on deck, Girard. Always interesting to hear all of the walk-up songs chosen. As Mosier takes off for second, she's going to make it in time. A stolen base and the pitch a strike. 0-1, but Herbolt now has a runner on second here. No outs. Gazelles at some point have to string some runs here. Some base hits as well. As Herbolt takes pitch 2 for a ball. 1-1. Herbolt, 0-1, fouls that one back. 1-2 here now. Flew out to center field earlier in the game. That was in the first inning of play. Here in the fourth, her second attempt. No swing as it hits the outside zone for strike 3. Another strikeout for Desiree Hinch on the mound here. Madison Girard. 7 strikeouts for Hinch here through 3 1/3 innings pitched. Gerard gets that put on the ground. Could be trouble. Gerard with lots of speed. She gets to first. A base hit. That will count as a base hit as Gerard has the first one of the game for the Gazelles. A perfectly placed bunt for Gerard advances Mosier to third. Madison Musfeldt now at the plate. Runners on first and third. Gazelles here needing to get some runs. Bottom of the fourth inning. Showing signs of bunt. They pull back, but Gerard will take off for second. Pitch was a ball. So Musfeldt has runners on second and third now. Pitch. Swing and a miss there for Musfeldt. One ball, one strike, one out. Two runners on here. Chase Drotzman on deck. Musfeldt takes that for a called strike two. Hinch, swing and a miss from Musfeldt as Desiree Hinch adds another one to her total. Stepping in for the Gazelles, number two, Jocelyn Burns. So Jocelyn Burns will be batting in place of Chase Drotzman here. Two outs, though, as Coach Seitz wants to go talk with both Desiree Hinch and Kaylee Drew, as Muth goes to the umpire for the substitution. But again, it's Jocelyn Burns, her first plate appearance here of the day. On deck, Haley Schulte, Gazelles needing to score a run here. And Burns steps into the box for the first time. Taking on again, Desiree Hinch. Doesn't get it with that swing, 0-1. Haley Schulte hoping to bat here in this inning. Burns takes that pitch, it's high, misses, ball one. One ball, one strike. Burns takes that. Just inside, a touch. 2-1. So Burns still working at the plate. Takes a cut at that one. Making the count 2-2. Straight back into the backstop. Two balls, two strikes, two outs, two runners on. Now the count's full. Burns wanting to reach by any means possible here. As she takes a cut, doesn't get it. That is strikeout number 9 for Hinch on the mound after 4 innings of play. Gazelles come away without any runs. They did get their first hit. It was Madison Gerard off of a bunt. She reached first safely. When we return, Raylan Sealer leads off for the Rough Riders.
Your invitation to thrive in Yankton, South Dakota. Nestled on the bluffs of the Missouri River, plenty of outdoor adventures are waiting. Whether you work remote or in a traditional office, we have a spot for you. Quality health care, diverse manufacturing, progressive school system, Mount Marty University, and so much more. Explore with family and friends. Let's thrive together.
TNRC Smith Insurance has been a part of the Yankton community since 1949. Our agency would love to help you with your home, auto, business, life, and long-term care insurance needs.
We take pride in providing you with quality service when you have a claim or need to make changes to your coverage.
The MT and RC Smith Insurance Agency is flexible to meet with you in person or at the office at 204 West 4th Street. Give them a call for insurance changes, payments, claims, or service requests.
Top of the fifth inning. Again, leading off for the Rough Riders, Raylan Sealer with Abigail Paulson on deck. Mackenzie Johnson in the hole. Torrey Hansen still working on the mound here for Yankton. Sealer right back to Hansen. She catches it, but just with the tip of her glove, one pitch, one out. Abigail Paulson now. Paulson 0 for 2, two strikeouts here. Hansen trying to make it number 3. First pitch is taken for a strike, 0-1. Hansen taking her time. Next pitch as showing sign of bunt from Paulson. Girard picks it up. The throw doesn't make it quite in time. Paulson able to reach by a bunt by about a quarter of an inch, but she'll be standing on first, a base runner with a base hit for Sioux Falls Roosevelt. Now Mackenzie Johnson at the plate, followed by Peyton Eckline. Johnson has one base hit and also flew out, has been hitting towards the right side, takes a swing, doesn't get it, 0-1. Gazelle's really needing to limit any runs given up here the rest of the game. Next pitch, barely inside. As one ball, one strike here is the count. Johnson, another swing and a miss. One ball, two strikes now. One ball, two strikes, one out here, one runner on. That pitch just misses for a ball. I think Mosier thought that they had Johnson there. But Johnson will see at least one more pitch here. And that one, I gotta say, not too sure where it missed, but count now full 3-2. With the full count, Torrey Hansen fires it, as that's called for strike 3, as stealing second is Paulson. But Mackenzie Johnson goes down with no swing. Peyton Eckline up to bat. There's two outs here. Again, Yankton really needing to force an inning with no runs given up here. In their last two innings in the field, they've given up 3 on each. Swing and a miss there from Carlson. Peyton Eckline. Carlson plays left field right. I've written right under on my scorecard, but it is not batted yet today. So Eckline, 0 for 2 on the day. Trying to get that first base hit. Showing signs of bunt. Pulls back. The steal to third. Throws well in time. And out at third is Paulson. Mosier with a big play there, and the first throw out on a steal from the Gazelles for the season. A good defensive inning of play headed into the bottom of the fifth. Leading off, it'll be Haley Schulte, Emma Iacker on deck, and Cameron Koletsky in the hole.
Continually strive to improve the quality of service we provide the Yankton community. The Garden of Memory Cemetery and Winston Ray Funeral Home are pleased to announce the completion of a brand new columbarium. This columbarium is constructed of granite, designed to withstand the test of time. It is for those families choosing cremation and features above ground outdoor niches, which includes a bronze plaque to memorialize your loved one, as well as indoor glass front niches where families can create a unique memorial with pictures or other family heirlooms. For more information, please give us a call at the Winston Ray Funeral Home in Yankton.
know what to do. Ever since my neighbor grew in, he just keeps pushing.
Move over! Y'all in my way! Hey, where do you keep those snacks around here? Hey, put me down!
So long, loudmouth.
Two is company, but three's a crowd.
Wisdom teeth mouthing off? Sounds like a job for Siouxland Oral Surgery. We're the oral surgery specialists with the tools and training to deliver better diagnoses, greater safety, and better outcomes.
Gazelles with a chance here to take back some of those runs. Again, leading off is Haley Schulte. Schulte, 0 for 1 today, struck out swinging in the third inning. Now batting right-handed. Takes the first pitch, called for a strike, as I believe it is not actually Schulte at the plate. Swing and a miss there. As it's Elena Nelson at the plate. Down 0-2 in the count. Takes the third pitch for strike three as, well, Hinge with yet again another. Emma Iacker will now bat for the third time in the game. She was walked in her last appearance. First pitch, strike called against Iacker. One out, no runners on here. Yankton at the top of their lineup. Koletsky on deck. Iacker cracks that one hard. Foul, though. 0-2 the count. An awfully nice sound off of the bat there. You could hear the crack of the bat. Put a little air on that. Straighten it out, and that one's probably going some distance. 0-2, though, as Iacker going to take one to the back of the head. Knocks her helmet off, but she doesn't look fazed in the slightest bit. She's heading to first with a bean. She's just happy to get on for her team. Cameron Koletsky now batting. One out and a runner on here. Gazelles, time to start chipping away at that lead held by Sioux Falls Roosevelt. As Koletsky takes the first pitch, inside for a ball. Next pitch on the way, Koletsky takes it for ball two. So two balls, no strikes here. Koletsky 0 for 1 today, struck out, but was also walked in the first inning, made it to third. Takes a cut at that one, doesn't get it. Iacker taking off for second. She makes it safe. That almost felt like a delayed steal. It didn't look like she took off right away, but Iacker with good speed, so she was able to make it. Throw was not there even if it had been on time. Runner on second now here for Koletsky. Misses that one. Two balls, two strikes here. Again, Koletsky, a player that Muth said expect her at some point, one of these games, she's going to have a big one at the plate. Takes that pitch. It's outside. Count now full at 3-2. Bottom of the fifth inning here. Big at bat here for Cameron Koletsky. As she swings, doesn't get it. Strikeout number two here in the fifth inning. Kyra Churchma. Now batting, 0 for 2 today. A good base hit could score Iacker from second. That pitch finds its way into the strike zone, 0-1. As a grounder right back up to Hinch, as the throw over to first is going to make it well in time. After five, the score will remain 6-0 on top, the Rough Riders. Two innings of play left here. When we return, Peyton Eckline was the final out, so it'll be Reisenweber leading off for Sioux Falls Roosevelt.
There's a whole new world out there. It's called the off-road, and it's waiting to be explored in a Polaris. So gear up to make every moment count with the Polaris off-road vehicle. The new Polaris 2024 models are in at Stockman's Motorsports in Yankton. Get ready to tackle the trails this winter. With machines like these, your world just gets bigger. Stop in at Stockman's Motorsports today to learn more about the epic new Polaris off-road lineup.
AR's Oasis in Yankton, your one-stop store for everything you need. The parking lot, it's the biggest in town for ease of getting in and out. Oh, and the selection they have inside, it's unbeatable. Energy drinks, coffee, pop, and even something for the adults. Now the food selection, they only give me 30 seconds, but there's daily specials posted right on the outside, along with burgers, ribs, and so much more. JR's Oasis, Highway 50 East, Yankton.
Top of the sixth inning here again. Two innings of play left here, showing sign of bunt. As it is actually Eckline. I didn't trust my work on the paper. Eckline leads off. On deck will be Reisenweber. That pitch outside. Ball two. 2-0 now the count. So Eckline 0 for 2 in the game. That pitch misses inside, now 3-0 the count. Eckline hasn't had to swing yet. As that one does find the strike zone, now 3-1. Three balls, one strike, no outs, no runners on here. Eckline, the leadoff batter for the Rough Riders in the top of the sixth. As a hard hit grounder picked up by Churchma, she's got the throw, out number one. Churchma is as solid as they come at shortstop here. Makes big plays frequently and the routine ones. That'll bring up Reisenweber here. Kaylee Drew on deck for the Rough Riders. First pitch is in for strike one. Oh, one, one out. That pitch is also in for a strike. 0-2 the count. Tori Hansen up in the count against Reisenweber. Reisenweber, 1-for-2, has a single, was walked. As she's going to dribble that one back up to Hansen, picks it up, out number two. So a good start defensively here for the Gazelles in the top of the sixth. Kaylee Drew at the plate. 1-for-2, hit a single in the third, grounded out in the fourth, and was hit by a pitch in the first inning. First pitch outside for a ball. One ball, no strikes, two outs, no runners on here. As that one outside for ball two. Kaylee True looking. Drew looking to get that second base hit here in the game. Here's the next pitch. No swing, it's ball three. Hansen did go down 3-0 earlier in a count, did end up getting the out, so we'll see if she can do it again. Well, she's got the first strike there. Next pitch to Drew. Drew nearly hit by it, but it's going to be a walk. As another runner here for the Rough Riders. As I believe they have had a runner every inning on base, and they have Desiree Hinch batting. She's 2-for-3, but also reached by error. Had a very good day on the mound and at the plate so far. As she cracks that one out of play. Behind that one. Oh, on the count. One runner on first with Kaylee Drew standing there. The pitch, Hinch gets that one high up into right field, drifting further out of play. It's going to land foul. Oh, 2 the count. Fouled out of play again. The good old sound effects here at Sertoma Park. As that one, a hard shot fouled down the third baseline. I mean, Hinch making good contact here. Oh, 2 the count has been for the last couple pitches here. Desiree Hinch. Working against Hansen. She's going to crack that one hard into right field. It's going to land fair. It's a base hit. Heading for third is Drew. Hinch on second. Drew headed for third. Home. She scores. Hinch going for it all. She has it. And in the park home run from Desiree Hinch. You don't see those too often. But she put on the wheels and she made it all the way home, back home. 8-0 now your score on the Fox Stop scoreboard. 2 outs, Carly Felsheim at the plate. 2-for-3, has 2 singles in the game. As she cracks that one hard in deep into left center. It could be. It's gone. It's out of here. A home run hit by Carly Felsheim. Make that score 9-0. The first one over the fence, but the second one in 2 batters here for Sioux Falls Roosevelt. And in the park, followed up by one over the fence. Aaliyah Chagola has to follow up the back-to-back home runs. Not a fun job. As now it looks like Muth heading out to the mound. We'll see if Hansen remains or if they are going to bring in relief. 2 outs. Hansen will remain on the mound. Aaliyah Chagola. Has a grounder hit there. Scooped up by Churchma. Will the throw make it? It won't. Churchma with a good effort being able to even scoop that up. But Chagola standing on first with a single. Again, another base runner here for Sioux Falls Roosevelt. Raylan Sealer at the plate with Abigail Paulson on deck. As every inning the Rough Riders have scored, they've scored exactly three runs. So fresh count here for Sealer. As we do have a pinch runner on first. As that one's hit high up into right field, Schulte gets under it and comes down with it for out number three, top of the sixth inning now over. With the Gazelles even more to be done at the plate now, as leading off will be Peyton Mosier, followed by Emma Herbolt and Madison Gerard in the hole. On 5-star streaming on YouTube.
Piper, the sign says it all. Flowers and gifts. The store is bustling with something new all the time. There are flowers for any occasion, weddings, anniversary, birthday, or just to say I love you. There's coffee, soups, dips, and sweets. Need to give someone a chuckle? The socks say it all. Home decor, candles, jewelry, memorial items are all found at your gift store of Pied Piper Flowers and Gifts, corner of 15th and Broadway in Yankton. You can also shop online, and best of all, we deliver too.
From sunup to sundown, the work ethic of the farmer is unquestioned. As farming methods change and evolve, you need a financial partner to help you reach your goals. Elkhorn Valley Bank's experienced lenders are committed to providing dependable advice and fast local decisions, no matter the size of the operation. From farmland to livestock, you can count on us today and in the future. Elkhorn Valley Bank and Trust. There really is a difference.
Bottom of the sixth inning of play. Gazelles have six outs here to make it happen. Hinch's first pitch inside to Mosier on now batting. Emma Herbolt on deck. Madison Gerard in the hole. Mosier takes that one inside as well. Again, the score 9-0. So Yankton really needing some runs here. As Mosier got a piece of that one. So two balls, one strike here. No outs and no runners on. Mosier got a piece of that one too and fouls it straight back. Now 2-2 the count. As Desiree Hinch on the mound has just been pretty much untouchable. She's done a very good job. As swing and a miss there for Mosier. Another strikeout to add to Hinch's total. Gazelles with five outs here to score nine runs. So now with an out, Herbolt got a piece of that one straight out of play, though. Oh, one the count. That pitch low and inside, ball one. Next pitch, in for a strike. Herbolt now down 1-2 in the count. has that one. The outside zone there. Two balls, two strikes here. Herbert trying to get on base for the Gazelles. As she goes down swinging. Strikeout number two here in the sixth inning. Madison Girard, one for two. She has the lone hit here in the game for the Gazelles. It was a bunt that got by Hinch on the mound over to second. We'll see if we have that same strategy or not. First pitch is high, misses it's a ball. As she gets a piece of that one, hit high up. Drew's going to have a chance at it as Kaylee Drew does catch it. Gazelles down to three total outs, and they need nine runs to come up with it. For the Rough Riders, have to be feeling good headed into the final inning of play. When we return, leading off will be Abigail Paulson, followed by Mackenzie Johnson and Peyton Eckline.
Seasons Power Sports in Yankton can help make your life easier and more fun. All Seasons Power Sports can help you with ATVs, side-by-sides, fishing and pleasure boats, as well as motorcycles, watercraft, and more. Check out their inventory at AllSeasonsPowerSportsInc.com. All Seasons Power Sports, your authorized Honda and Yamaha dealer on your way to the lake in Yankton.
At Avera, we believe good health starts early, and that good health care can inspire a life of wellness. At Avera, we believe in push-ups and pumping iron. We believe less is more, and live for apple slices instead of apple pie. At Avera, we live for staying healthy and enjoying the little things. We're invested in healthy living so you can live longer.
Leading off here in the top of the seventh inning, it's Abby Paulson. Takes the first pitch outside, ball one. Mackenzie Johnson on deck. Gets a piece of that, a grounder, scooped up at second. The throw to first is good, out number one. Play made by Jocelyn Burns in place of Chase Drotzman. So Paulson grounds out to start the seventh inning. Mackenzie Johnson at the plate. She'll foul that out of play. Oh, 1 now the count. That one inside. 1-1 now the count. One ball, one strike here. That pitch low for ball number two. That pitch misses for a ball. As that one a grounder, Churchma fields it cleanly and gets a throw out number two. So Peyton Eckline, her fourth appearance at the plate today. She faces two outs, no runners on. She's 0 for 3 today, trying to get that first base hit. And again, it's really for the Gazelles on defense. It's been three innings. Otherwise, they've held strong throughout. The first two innings, no runs. Then third and fourth, they gave up three runs apiece. Same with the fifth and the sixth. Fifth inning, no runs given up. The sixth, they gave up three. First pitch, a strike against Eckline. Next pitch, swing and a miss there from Eckline. 0-2 the count. Hansen could get the final out for her team here on the mound. No balls, two strikes. Fouled off towards the Gazelles dugout. Ekline awaits the next pitch from Hansen as she fouls that one off and out of play. On deck, Kylie Reisenweber awaits. Oh, two the count. That pitch outside, ball one. That pitch also misses for a ball. 2-2 now. Tori Hansen trying to go the full seven innings here for the Gazelles. Seems very likely she will do so. As a grounder. Doesn't get through, but it will be a base hit here for Ekline. Her first base hit of the game. And the 11th, I believe, for Sioux Falls Roosevelt in total. So Kylie Reisenweber, another chance here. A grounder hit over to Girard. She picks it up. She's got the throw, so no score here in the top of the 7th for Sioux Falls Roosevelt. As Reisenweber grounds out, Girard with a nice play at third. As Gazelles now, three outs between them. And this game, they need 9 runs to tie it up, 10 to take the lead. They're going to need a lot of runs. When we return, Madison Musfelt leads off, followed by Jocelyn Burns on deck. And we'll see if it's Haley Schulte or Elena Nelson in the hole. We'll be back in a moment on 5-Star Streaming on YouTube.
At Elwood Family Dental Care, we treat our patients like family. We have an experienced and caring dental team. We take the time to make sure you understand your oral health and answer any questions you have about your dental treatments. We take pride in educating our patients. Whether you need fillings, crowns or bridges, dental implants, just a teeth cleaning, or even Botox, come visit us at 1818 Broadway Avenue. And remember, we take care of the entire family.
As we heard, ball's in, coming down. Bottom of the 7th inning. Again, leading off will be Madison Musfelt here. As looks like we have a substitution. McKenna Hatcheski for the first time of the day will be batting. She'll face Hinch, the first pitch, low for a ball.
Yeah. All right, McKenna, you got it.
So Hatcheski at bat, Jocelyn Burns on deck. That pitch inside for ball two, 2-0 is the count. Again, Gazelles need base runners badly here. Hatcheski takes that for a strike. 2-1 now. Desiree Hinch still on the mound. She's played the whole game. Swing from Hatcheski, doesn't get it. 2-2 now. Hatcheski watches, it's outside, full count. As that one's called for strike three on the full count, one out here. Gazelles now have 2 outs. Jocelyn Burns at the plate now. Her second at bat, takes a swing, misses, 0-1 the count. Gazelles needing a heck of a 7th inning rally here. Burns takes that pitch, it's inside, ball one, 1-1 the count. Next pitch. Burns got a piece of it. It's going to be fouled out of play. Now one ball, two strikes here. It looks like Haley Schulte batting again here. Coming up. As that pitch called for a ball. 2-2, Burns still at the plate, and again, it's Haley Schulte on deck. As a swing and a miss there from Burns, another strikeout. Hinch on the mound is on fire. Now 15 strikeouts for Desiree Hinch on the mound. Haley Schulte at the plate. Takes the first pitch, called for a strike. So 5 innings worth of outs, all at the hands of Hinch. That pitch just barely misses, ball one. 1-1 the count. Pitch is low and outside. Ball two. Now needing a great two-out rally here are the Gazelles. They trail 9-0. As that one again, same spot. Low and outside. Haley Schulte trying to be the first base runner for her team since the fifth inning. As that one misses high, Schulte is on base. M. Iacker at the plate. She's 0-for-1, struck out, but she's been walked. She's been hit by a pitch. If the Gazelles pull this off, might be the greatest two-out rally of all time. First pitch is high. 1-0 is the count. Next pitch low, 2-0 the count now. So Desiree Hinch, after dominating this entire game, puts someone on base with a walk. Now she finds the strike zone again, 2-1 the count. As she hits that one up, it's caught and put away at first base by Peyton Eckline. Emma Iacker flies out for the third out of the seventh inning and the final out of the game. Final score on the Fox Stop scoreboard, 9-0 favoring Sioux Falls Roosevelt. The Fox Stop in Yankton at the corner of West City Limits Road and 31st in Northwest Yankton is open 5 a.m. to 9 p.m. daily. A full-service convenience store with hot food, sandwiches, munchies, and beverages. Pay at the pump, gas and diesel fuel, and firewood and propane tank exchange. Now at our First Dakota National Bank of Yankton post-game show, we await our chat that we always have with head coach Jill Muth after the game. Again, your final score, 9-0. When we return, we'll have the Gazelles' remaining schedule. What time we'll be live with games. All of that information coming up on our First Dakota post-game show. And again, Coach Muth needing to talk with her team. Then she'll make her way over here, come chat with us for a little bit. We'll be back in a moment on 5-Star Streaming on YouTube.
Being the first bank in South Dakota was the easy part. Earning the confidence of local farmers, helping families account for their dreams, and securing the future for countless businesses took us a little longer. We owe it to the hard workers, big dreamers, and forward thinkers out there. Thank you for making South Dakota a great place to call home.
Choose
Apache's Floor Tech Cleaning and Restoration, locally owned by Tom and Nancy Langdon since 1994, and because they offer so many services for residential and commercial properties, like carpet cleaning, mold testing and removal, fire and smoke damage, and duct cleaning. Floor Tech Cleaning and Restoration also offers emergency services in Yankton, Mitchell, Southeast South Dakota, Northeast Nebraska, and Norfolk.
Whether a broken pipe or flooding rain, when your home or floor is wet, call Floor Tech.
Located at 220 East 3rd Street in Yankton.
Horizon Healthcare in Yankton offers medical, dental, and behavioral health services for all, from tooth pains to aches and pains. Our new location on 920 Broadway Avenue is a comfortable, expanded space where everyone is welcome. Whether insured, uninsured, Medicaid, or Medicare, here in Yankton, we care for all. And that's what we care about most. Call to schedule your appointment at Horizon Healthcare.
Interior technicians.
I'm ready for my big role, Jerry.
What do you mean?
You said I'd be in your next 30 commercials.
No. I said InTech has over 30 years of commercial cleaning experience. You know, like offices, so they can ensure happy visitors and a healthy workforce.
So the shoot's in an office? I can make that work.
Oh my goodness. When you need it clean, call the InTech team.
Kaiser Heating and Cooling is your local source for heat and glow fireplaces, gas inserts, and wood stoves. Also home to the Train HVAC systems, humidifiers, dehumidifiers, and mini splits. Whether building or remodeling, the team of experts will get you the right size of HVAC system for your home or business. The ductwork is made in-house, and then the installers will get your Train system installed in no time to keep you cool in the summer and warm in the winter. Kaiser Heating and Cooling since 1948.
New year, new flooring. I plan on saying hello with new flooring from Larson Carpet in Yankton. Larson Carpet will help with design and installation. They have a great selection of carpet, vinyl, luxury vinyl plank, hardwood, and tile. Stop in and let them help you get a new look in the new year. Larson Carpet at 208 Walnut Street in the Meridian District in Yankton. For the best flooring for your space, lifestyle, and budget, see Larson Carpet.
And back on our First Dakota National Bank postgame show, First Dakota National Bank of Yankton has proudly supported the dreams and banking needs of their customers for over 150 years. They offer personal, business, and ag banking solutions for every stage of your journey with two locations, downtown and North Broadway Yankton. Again, we usually get a chat with head coach Jill Muth after the games. Looks like she and the other coaches are out past third base still talking. As we wait, we'll take a look at the remainder of the Yankton Gazelles' schedule. Of course, still early in the season. They led off the season against Brandon Valley. They lost 4-7. Then they took on Harrisburg. They lost 18-1. Here tonight against Sioux Falls Roosevelt, it was 9-0. Now they'll take on Rapid City Central this Thursday. So I'll be there live with that. Of course, first pitch is at 5. I'll try to go live right around 4:30. Try and get coach interviews, of course. We only got one coach interview today, and that was Muth, as always. But Rapid City Central, 5 o'clock is that game, 4:30 pregame. And then Friday, again, I'll be covering the Gazelles as at noon they play Spearfish, and at 4 it's Pier TF Riggs. Again, that is not really a doubleheader. It's against two different teams, but we will be covering both games. They then travel to take on T Area in a 4 o'clock matchup. Now, last year we really just kind of covered the home games. This year we are expanding a little bit of our coverage. We will be traveling to T Area and covering that game. Again, that's on the 15th. And looking ahead, the couple that we're not sure we'll be able to make against Sturgis Brown and Rapid City Stevens. But We'll for sure be there. Their next home game is against Watertown. Another one we're not sure we'll be able to make, Aberdeen Central on the 27th. That's a 4 o'clock game. Of course, we'll keep you updated on all of our games on our website, kvht.com, or stay tuned to Classic Hits 106.3, and we'll let you know what games we're covering. Against Vermilion, a home game, the final game of April, we will for sure be covering that one. They then travel to take on O'Gorman, first game of May, then at Mitchell at against Mitchell at home. They then travel twice in a row, take on Brookings, Sioux Falls, Lincoln, and then in the final regular season game of the year, they'll take on Sioux Falls, Jefferson. That is May 16th at 6 o'clock, and we will be there for that. Now joining me, it's Coach Jill Muth. Jill, a tough game out there today, but it was really just a few innings that didn't kind of really go your way.
Yeah, they... You know, really, I think we'll start with Tori Hansen pitched all seven innings for us and gave up, I don't know, the scoreboard said 9. We thought it was 8. What'd you have?
I did have 9 on mine, so.
So I don't know. Either way, it doesn't matter. But, you know, I thought really she pitched pretty well, you know. She's getting confidence, and she doesn't throw real hard, you know. So hers is going to be a matter of control and spin. And when it's hard, when it's cold, it's hard to get that spin on the ball. So, I mean, really, for the most part, other than a couple innings, like you said, and one pitch here and there, she really did pitch a pretty good game. Offensively, boy, their pitcher's good. She's a freshman, and she throws hard, and we just had a hard time seeing it, I mean, I think we got one hit, a bunt hit in the fifth or sixth inning. I mean, you know, same thing we've been talking about. We need to have practice. We need to have practice so we can get out and get some at-bats and get some swings on the pitching machine and, you know, get a set of ball outside off on a tee and get some hits. But, I mean, we got some work to do, but I think our girls battled. You know, every kid went in there and you know, was working hard at it and trying. You know, I can't question our effort. Just got to keep working at getting better.
And so now a few games left in this week. On Thursday, you have one game, two games on Friday, and as the wind picks up, I'll keep it quick for you, Muth.
It's right.
A little chilly, but upcoming a few games. Is it going to be nice to actually have a couple practices between games now?
Yes, it is nice to be able to get a few practices in here and see if we can work on some things and maybe come out and look a little better on Thursday and Friday.
And is there anything specific that the practices are going to look like? Or
you know, we're going to work on some bunting. We're going to work on just getting some swings at live balls, you know, just setting the pitching machines up and having the girls hit. And we're going to work on some base running, just working on pads and coming around. Those are a couple things that we talked about having to work on.
All right, well, sounds great. We'll see you in action again Thursday, like I said, and then Friday twice. We'll be here waiting for you, as always, and we'll talk to you then.
All right, sounds good. Thanks, Zach.
See you Thursday, 2:15.
Again, that was head coach Jill Muth of the Yankton Gazelles on our First Dakota National Bank of Yankton post-game show. It's a cold night here at Sertoma Park. Your final scoreboard reads 9-0 with Sioux Falls Roosevelt on top of the Gazelles. Again, for the final time, I'm Zach Spear on 5-Star Streaming on YouTube alongside Corbin Gunther and Gage Ravelette. Have a great night, and we'll see you next time for Gazelle Softball.